May I now invite Dr. Jayaraman Mahadevan. Dr. Jayaraman Mahadevan is the Director of Research Department at Krishnamacharya Yoga Mandiram based in Chennai. He holds a PhD degree on the work called Tantra Yukti, which is the ancient method of thesis writing. So he has worked and he has developed many training workshops and courses based on that. And he's also involved in the textual research with regard to yoga. So one of the finer contributions is the coming up of the platform called Yoga Vaisharadi, which is a digital platform where we can find many texts of yoga along with their commentaries in multiple languages, all available in one place, that is Yoga Vaisharadi platform. And similarly, he has also come up with a text called Yogasya Bhasha Sanskritam, which is a 4-volume book, which will help a beginner to get into Sanskrit through Yoga Sutras. So it's a very unique book, which is available. And along with this, he has also published nearly 14 books and umpteen number of papers in national and international journals. And today he's a known name in the field of textual research in the field of yoga. So with this brief introduction, I'd like to invite Dr. Jayaraman Mahadevan to share a little bit about the Vedic and traditional perspectives of Surya Namaskar practice. Over to you, Dr. Jaira.
Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Namaste to one and all. And thank you, Dr. Vinay Chandra, for that introduction. And it is indeed an honor to be part of this launch program of Suryathan app. So I'll just go into my presentation here, or my thoughts about Surya and Surya Namaskar in Vedic tradition and its traditional Vedic spiritual roots. So many speakers, Dr. Nagendra ji and others, have already hinted about it. I would like to start with a quotation from the Vedas, a mantra from the Vedas, which was chanted at the beginning in the invocation. Tat suryasya devatvam tanmahitvam madhyakartor vitatagam sanjabhara. This was the mantra which was chanted initially during the invocation. It is in the first mandala of Rigveda, 115th sukta. It is a mantra which was seen by Kutsa Angirasa Rishi. So what does he say? What does Surya symbolize? Or what does Surya stand for according to our Rigvedic Rishis? This is a beautiful, unique, new perspective about Surya, where he says, that is the greatness of Surya, Tat Suryasya Mahitvam and Tat Suryasya Devatvam. That is the godhood of Surya. So what makes Surya great? What makes Surya the god? So it, the sage Angirasa says, Madhyakartor vitatagam sanjabhara. So he doesn't, in the sense, he is a free spirit. Whoever might be doing anything, so he doesn't stop for anyone else to complete their work. He will not retain his light. So the commentator Sayanacharya, there he says that a farmer is yet to complete his day's work in the field. Surya will not wait for him. He will just withdraw his rays and just move ahead. Vitatagam sanjabhara. So that is devatva and that is the mahitva. Means that the free spirit, he is not limited. He is not restrained by anything. He symbolizes freedom. So that is why he is a god and that is why he is great. This is the view of Surya in our Vedas. The Rishis saw Surya as a symbol of a freedom. And this is one perspective about Surya. So in my talk, I will speak about Surya and then Surya Namaskar, because it's very important that we see these two dimensions. So this is the very first reference from the Vedas that I just wanted to present. The spirit of freedom that Surya symbolizes as seen by sage Angirasa. And not only that, various names of Surya, that is next to Agni and next to Indra, Surya is the divinity which is glorified, celebrated in the Vedas for the multifarious influences that he has on the lives on the earth. So the sages celebrate Surya as Mitra. Udyanadya Mitra Mahaha. This mantra was also chanted in the beginning. So he is a friendly mass of light rising in the morning. So that's how the Vedas celebrate Surya. And Surya is seen as a friendly mass of light. And then Pusha, Nagendraji spoke about this, the nourisher. Surya is seen as Pusha. And then Aditya, the son of Aditi, the son of Mother Earth. So he is the one. So just like the son or just like the child sleeping on the lap of the mother. Similarly, while setting, he goes to the lap of the Mother Earth, Aditi. So hence he is Aditya. So he comes, he goes round and round and he takes care of the earth. So in that sense, he is celebrated as Aditya. And then Savita, the progenitor, the one who gives lives. And then of course, Surya itself. Surya itself means the one who inspires. Surya, Preraka, that's the word that Sayanacharya uses to mean, what to describe the word Surya. Preraka, the inspirer. Sage Vishwamitra, that's why he presented the Surya mantra, the Gayatri mantra as Prachodaya, the inspirer. And Vishnu is also a solar divinity in the Rigveda Samhita. So Vishu Vyaptav, Surya pervades the earth, the atmosphere and also the heaven. So that is the three steps of Vishnu. Trini Pada Vichakrame, Vishnur Gopa Ada Abhyaha. So the sunlight pervading the earth, Bhuhu, Bhuvaha, Suvaha. So in that sense also, the Vedic Rishi is celebrated. So for the material world, as a nourisher, as a friend, as a giver of life, Surya was seen. Surya was seen as a spirit of freedom in the Vedas. And also, previously we had a mention that Surya was also seen as a source of energy, which is also a reality, which is also a truth. Aditya Havai Bahya Pranaha. So he is the external source of prana, energy. The Prashnopanishad puts it this way. So in the material dimension, Surya has been seen in all perspective possibles, possible by the Vedic seers. And that's why the way the Vedic mantra also celebrates Surya Atma Jagatas Tasthushascha. He's the soul of the mobile and also the stationary entities that is there in this universe. And these are from the material dimensions. And there was also a scientific knowledge about, there are at least hints about the Surya. So where we see in the Taittiriya Aranyaka, Aruna Prashna, we see apashyamahametat suryamandalam parivartamanam. Rishi says, I see the suryamandala rotating. This is what he says. So Surya is not seen as stationary. Suryamandala parivartamana, suryamandala, it is rotating. And the Vedic seers were also aware of multiplicity of the suns. When they say, saptadisho nana suryaha, there are nana surya, there is not one surya, there are so many suryas. So in this way, we see from the material perspective, from the inspirational perspective, from the scientific perspective, there was a very solid, balanced view. And the Vedic seers were very much inspired by the sun and of course, the spiritual dimension, as was mentioned previously by Nagendra Ji, say, tatvam pushan apavrunu. Satya Dharmaya Drishtaye Pusha, the nourisher of positive knowledge. So let him unravel and present the glorious, indwelling, pure consciousness. And then every day during Sandhyavandana, we say Asavadityo Brahma. So this shining orb of brightness is nothing but the representation of the pure consciousness that pervades the entire universe. So in this way, that there is the Vedic seers were just lovers of sun in all its dimensions, spiritual, material, source of energy, source of inspiration, and then a symbol of freedom. So, and of course, in later literature, taking inspiration from this love for Surya, from the Vedas, we see in the Bhagavad Gita also, we see Adityanam Aham Vishnuhu. So among the sons, the sun solar divinities, Dvadasha Adityas, I am Vishnu. Krishna says in the Vibhutipada, Divi Surya Sahasrasya Bhaved Yugapad Uthita, the effulgence and the glory of the sun. So the glory of Paramatman, how can it be compared to? It is as if thousands of suns are rising at the same time. One of the nuclear scientists in the West, when he saw this atom bomb explosion, so he referred to this Bhagavad Gita verse. So sun was everywhere there, be it in the Vedas, later in the Bhagavad Gita, and in Ramayana, we see that sage Agastya gives this Aditya Hridaya to Rama so that he moves, chants the Surya Mantra, gets inspired by that, and then defeats the demon Rakshasa. So in this way, sun, Surya was always there in the Hindu Vedic consciousness since the dawn of the civilization. And so this is about Surya, the love for Surya, the sun-centric way of life. And was it merely an intellectual or philosophical or a notional affinity that this Vedic civilization had to sun? Or did anything convert into action? Was there any namaskara? Was there any action? Was there any movement towards aligning with the sun? So when we see, then comes the context of Surya Namaskara. So Surya, of course, Surya was adored, respected, loved, and there was effort in the Vedic civilization to align with the sun. So that is where we find Surya Namaskara into the context. It was not a mere utopian love for a particular entity which fascinates the mind. It is also a practical understanding of connecting with the sun, which is very beneficial for life also. And the very activity which is called as Sandhyavandana is an activity which is intended to align every human being under the sun, to align oneself with the sun. So when this alignment with the movement of the sun is lost, that's where we lose everything. The current day civilization is suffering in various dimensions, various fronts, because of this lack of alignment with the movement of the sun. There is this Prata Sandhyavandana. So in the Vedic way of life, the day dawned with the sun. So a person started his day with the Prata Sandhyavandana, salutation of the rising sun, taking inspiration and energy from the rising sun. And then in the midday again, there is Madhyannika, where again he associated himself with the and reflected upon how the previous portion, the forenoon, was spent, and he recalibrated himself for the next part of the day. And then at the end of the day, just before the sunset, in the light of the setting sun, again there is Sandhyavandana, sun salutation. Then the day ends there. The day does not go any further for the Vedic seer or Vedic person in the Vedic civilization. So along with the setting of the sun, the activities of human beings also ended. And one more thing, this was not again mere joining the hands and doing salutation, namaskara. We see one of the greatest acharyas of yoga, Krishnamacharya, he wrote a text called Sandhya Sara. What is the essence of Sandhyavandana? Sandhyavandana incorporates asana, dhyana, pranayama, namaskara, every activity. We say namaskara has 8 dimensions, 8 types of namaskaras are there. Urasa by the head, Urasa by the chest, Shirasa by the head, Drishtya by the eyes, Manasa by the mind, Vachasa by the speech, Padbhyam by the feet, Karabhyam by the hands, Janubhyam by the knees. So namaskara is done by these 8 limbs in Surya Namaskara, and hence in Sandhyavandana. So hence Sandhyavandana itself is the traditional origin of Surya Namaskara. And this has been explicitly clarified in the 20th century treatise by Krishnamacharya in his text Sandhya Sara. And hence, so apart from a notional or a thought which is centered on Surya, the activity of aligning the life with Surya. So that also was there as part of Sandhyavandana. It was, as we see, this Surya Sandhyavandana, which is Surya Namaskara, which is full of yoga, was not only done by men, it was done by women also. We see in Ramayana, Sandhyakala Mana Shyama Dhruvam Eshyati Janaki Nadim Chemam Shubhajalam Sandhyarthe Varavarnini. So Hanuman is waiting on the Shimshapa tree in the Ashoka Vana. Nearby that, a river is flowing and a small stream is flowing. And he says, Hanuman says to himself, let me wait here because Sita will come here to perform her Sandhyavandana, the evening sun salutation, so that I can spot her. So in this way, it was done by men, it was done by women, and it included Urasa, Shirasa, Drishtya, Padbhyam, Karabhyam, Janubhyam, every limb was involved, Ashtangas were involved. Hence, this Sandhyavandana is the origin, which is there in the Vedas itself, Aharahas Sandhyam Upasita. So that is the origins of Surya Namaskara in the Vedas, in the Vedic tradition, as part of Sandhyavandana. And the entire universe is embracing this Sandhyavandana as a dimension of Surya Namaskara. And then, of course, specific texts are there where the Aruna Prashna, the first chapter of Taittiriya Aranyaka itself is called as Surya Namaskara Prashna, about 130 Anuvakas or sections are there. After chanting each of this, the Ashtanga Namaskara, Sashtanga Namaskara is done. And even in the same way, in Samaveda also, in the Aranyaka Gana portion, I have written an article about it, Elements of Yoga in Samaveda, which was published in the Darshanam magazine of Krishnamacharya Yoga Mandiram. There we see, even in Samaveda, there is a Surya Namaskara portion where it is chanted and Namaskara is performed. So, and it is from this timeless or very ancient tradition of Surya, regard and love for Surya in all its dimension, and also aligning ourselves by the performance of Sandhyavandana and other such rituals, that this Surya Namaskara has been given such an importance in our tradition. And later, so based on this Vedic inspiration, Acharyas like Krishnamacharya, they developed much more systematic practices. The asana-oriented Surya Namaskara that we see, that comes from this Vedic, solid Vedic source. And Acharyas like Krishnamacharya and the erstwhile, the king of the erstwhile kingdom, Aund, the Raja of Aund, Bhavan Rao, Srinivas Rao, Pant Pratinidhi. So all these, they systematically developed this, and hence this is a very much indigenous system of Surya and Surya Namaskara here. For that, this app has been developed. And I congratulate the creators of this app and all the organizations that are associated in this activity of promoting Surya Namaskara globally. And so, Pashyema Sharadashyatam, Jivema Sharadashyatam, Nandama Sharadashyatam. So, with this prayers for long life in alignment with sun, so I conclude my talk. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jayaraman. It was a very insightful talk about the essence of Surya, the whole Vedic lexicon, and also in our everyday lives.